This is a tutorial for creating a keychain model in SolidWorks. To start, open SolidWorks and create a new file. Select part for the file type and click OK. Then go up to Options, and under the Document Properties tab, select Units, and set your units to IPS, inch pound second. On the screen, you'll see the universal coordinate system, and in the model tree are the front, top, and right planes. Select all these planes and then right-click and select Show. The first step of the keychain is creating the extrusion. In the Features tab, select the Extrude Boss Base tool, and then select the front plane, which will be our sketching plane. SolidWorks is now in Sketcher mode, so select the center rectangle icon from the drawing menu. Click on the origin and a point in the upper right corner in order to create your rectangle. To dimension the rectangle, click on Smart Dimension and Horizontal Line. Then click on the horizontal line of the rectangle and modify the dimension to 1.5 inches. Then select Smart Dimension and Vertical Line and click on the vertical line of the rectangle, modifying the dimension to 2.5 inches. To create fillets on the rectangle, select the fillet icon in the drawing menu, and then select the lines connecting each corner. Once all four fillets are selected, on the left-hand side, change the fillet parameter to 1/8 or 0.125. To create the keychain hole, click on the circle on the drawing menu and then click inside the sketch to place the circle. Next, select Smart Dimension and dimension the distance between the center of the circle and the top horizontal line. Modify this dimension to 0.25 inches. Next, dimension between the center of the circle and the left vertical line. Modify the value to 0.75 inches. If this pop-up appears, the center of your circle was already constrained to the center plane when you placed it. Adding a new dimension would overconstrain your sketch, so just select Make This Dimension Driven and click OK. With Smart Dimension still selected, click on the circle and then place a diameter dimension, modifying it to 0.27 inches. The sketch for your extrusion is now finished and you can select the Continue button to exit Sketcher. In the Boss Extrude menu on the left-hand side of the screen, change the thickness of the extrude to 0.25 inches. Click the green check mark to finish this step. You can now see the basic shape of your keychain in your model. Remember to save your work before you move on to the next step. Your classmates will all have very similar models, so it's always a good idea to put your name in the file name. Step 2 is creating the rectangular pocket in the keychain. To create the pocket, select the front face of the part, right-click and change the view to normal to this face. Select the extruded cut icon and then choose the corner rectangle in the drawing menu. Place the rectangle in the middle of your part and then create dimensions using Smart Dimension. The rectangular pocket should be a half inch from the top of the part and a quarter inch from each side. To create the fillets on the pocket, use the same method as previously described, selecting fillet and then selecting lines around each corner before changing the fillet parameter to 0.125. Click the green check marks on the left-hand side, and then the Continue button to finish the sketch. In the Cut Extrude menu on the left-hand side of the screen, change the depth to 0.125 inches. Rotate your part to make sure the cut is going in the right direction, inside the part, and then click the green check mark. You can see the finished rectangular pocket in your part. Step 3 is the freeform cut in the part. Select the bottom surface of the part and change the view to be normal to this surface using the right-click menu. Click on the spline tool in the drawing menu, and then draw a shape in the pocket by clicking on multiple points. Make sure the last point is the same as the first so that the shape is enclosed. Also make sure to consider whether the end mill on the machine you're using will be able to reach all the surfaces of your cut. You can delete and recreate the shape until you're happy with the design. Then click the green check mark. In the Features tab, click on the extruded cut icon, and then change the depth from blind to through all, and click on the green check mark. Check to make sure your cut is in the right direction, and then click the green check mark. You're now done with the CAD model for your keychain. Make sure to save your work and then move on to the next step of creating a milling program for your part in SolidCAM.